Well, a bill passed by the General Assembly and awaiting signature by Governor Easley is aimed at making it tougher for speeders, particularly those chronic speeders and drivers charged with excessive speed. So what does all this mean? Of course, it's Friday, so Attorney Carl Parrish is here from Parrish, Smith & Ramsey, here to sort it all out for us. What kind of impact is this going to have for people who just get everyday speeding tickets?
Well, it's the stats show that about 30% of all tickets get reduced to what we call improper equipment. That's no insurance points, no driving points. This has the impact now of having every ticket, even if it's still a non-moving violation, on your record. It allows the judges, prosecutors, police, insurance companies to be able to pull up and find out what you have done in the last 12 months or how often they check your record.
Okay. The system seems to be working pretty well over the years as it was. Why do you think this is changing now?
Well, it's there were significant complaints. I don't know if the News and Observer or the Charlotte paper, but they checked there's just tremendous amount of reductions, especially on high and excessive speeds. So in addition to the improper equipment issue, they now say if you get convicted of going 25 miles over the posted speed limit, you cannot get an improper equipment. You can't get what we call a prayer for judgment continued, both of which help you from keep you from losing your license.
So is that the kind of impact it's going to have on people who have excessive speeds, or is that going to change at all?
Yeah, the law has always been in this state, and the irony is if you get caught going over 80, that's a mandatory revocation of your license. Your insurance goes up 80% for 3 years. The 25 over can impact tickets all the way across the board, you know, 61 to 35, 71 to 45. I think it will have a significant increase on people losing their license, therefore probably losing their jobs, and their insurance will go through the roof.
Kind of interesting to see how this will all shake down.
Well, the concern is they wanted to say your third improper equipment was a conviction, therefore they definitely can increase your insurance. They didn't get it this time, but I'll bet you they'll try to get it next time.
All right. Thanks, Carl. Have a good weekend. Thanks for joining us today. Well, if you got a question for Ask a Lawyer, write us at P.O. Box 11847 in Winston-Salem. That is at 27116.